Welcome into episode 3 of my Fremenic Only Iron Man series. Before the last video, I mentioned that I passed the 3K subscriber mark. Well, after that video came out, I ran right past the 4K mark as well, and I'm closing in on 5K at the time of this recording. The support for this series has been so much more than I could have ever thought, so thank you to everybody who's supported me so far and left any comments or feedback in the comment section of any of my videos. I do read every comment, so if I don't respond, I still do read them over, and I thank everybody for their feedback on that. But without further ado, let's hop into episode 3. Beginning off episode 3 in a familiar spot, with these buried bones, I will now get level 30 prayer. I've gotten 6 or 7 levels just from these ice trolls, and I can foresee myself getting all the way up to 43 at one point, because this is my best prayer training method by far. Unless I do go back to chickens, I can kill them a lot faster, but I like the passive XP that I get from this, as well as getting the rare drops. Did a little bit of AFKing at Rock Crabs, and there is level 45 defense. That's going to put me at base 45s for melee. So 45 is pretty important, because at that level I can now wear the Fremenic helms. I think I'll go for the archer helm first though, because I'm eventually going to get my range up, and I'm going to try and do primarily range going forward. But these stats will still be important, and I can always AFK here at Rock Crabs if I ever need to get those stats up. So there's one underground mine in Jatizo, and it has some tin ore, so I'm able to level up my mining from level 1 all the way up to level 15. Unfortunately, there's only tin ore, so I need to go buy all the copper ore, but they're only 4 or 5 GP each, so it wouldn't be too bad. And then I can make some more arrows. And there we have 1,950 more bronze arrows made. I picked up 2 smithing levels, 2 woodcutting levels, and 2 fletching levels, so not too bad. And we passed the 550 total mark as well. Back at the ice trolls, and there is level 32 prayer. All right, there we go. That is the first rune drop that I've gotten, the rune warhammer. I may use this as my main hand weapon, but I may just stick with the rune longsword. If I sell this in the shop, it's going to be giving me about 25k, so I may do that instead to get an archer helm quicker. And there we have a second rune warhammer in this inventory, so there we go. That's going to be about 50k or so there, so I think I'm going to sell both of these and go ahead and get myself an archer helm once I hit level 45 range. Okay, so I'm glad that I looked right after I got that second warhammer, but it actually turns out you only need level 45 defense for the helms. You don't need level 45 range, so I'm glad I didn't waste any time there. And the rune warhammer sell for 29k in the shop here. That's more than they high alk for. Somebody that recently watched episode 1 kind of let me know about this, so thank you very much for that. And with selling this, it's going to be 99k, almost 100, but here goes 78k of that now. And there we go, the archer helm. So that's going to give me plus 6 range and then a lot of defensive stats as well. This should help me out a little bit more efficiently training range. And 3 kills in from getting the archer helm, there is my first rune kite shield. So I think I'll hold on to this one. It will be my best in slot tank gear for quite some time. Maybe the granite shield would be better, but I think I need level 50 defense for that off the gate. So there we go, a rune kite shield and 2 rune warhammers in like the last 30 kills or so. That's pretty lucky. So one thing I haven't really explained in the first couple of episodes is my progression that I plan on going through to reach the DKs. My very next step I'm going to go for is completing the Horror from the Deep quest. As mentioned in episode 1, it is one of my exceptions being made because it does require me to leave the area during the quest. But the majority of the quest and the end of it does take place at the lighthouse, which is fair game for me. Why I need to do that is because the reward gives me from level 20, I'm sorry, it gives me level 1 to level 20 magic right off the bat. And as of now, I cannot get mind runes unless I kill these things called like Wallasalkies or something. They're level 98 in the Waterbirth dungeon and they hit with strong magic attacks, so I would for sure get just destroyed there without protect from magic. And they only drop them commonly 1 to 10 in drops, so I can just do the quest and get level 20 right off the bat. I can jump right into chaos, and then that will lead me to killing skeleton Fremenics. In my next episode, I do plan on giving like a full roadmap of how I plan to reach the DKs, including future progression past Horror from the Deep and so on. But my very first goal for Horror from the Deep is that I need to hit level 35 agility, And there's really no agility training spots except for a couple rocks that I can jump between that give me 2 experience each. So I'm gonna go and check that area out quickly after this. But I just kind of wanted to break it down just so I'm more clear on where I'm headed on the account, so it doesn't look like I'm just mindlessly chopping these logs or fletching. Another thing that I really need to aim for is level 54 fletching, which is going to give me the Mithril crossbow. That's going to be my best weapon to kill the Daggernoth Mother during the quest. If I get my smithing up and get some stronger bolts, I can hit close to 15, which would double my range hit as opposed to the maple shortbow. So that's why I'm focusing a lot on woodcutting and fletching, just because it's going to be important later on. I do need level 56 woodcutting for the future quests, and then level 61 fletching will get me the adamant crossbow at one point, but I think I can do the quest with just the mithril, so I won't waste my time going for such a long grind if I can do it just with the myth crossbow. And now, with all of that being said, let's head over to the lighthouse and I can show you my agility spot. So the Horror from the Deep quest requires level 35 agility, and then also I believe the Fremy Isles quest requires level 40 agility. So I think this is my best training spot, just because I'm at level 16, and if you jump across here, you get 2 experience. I think this is a spot where you can't fail, so I can just keep kind of doing this over and over. I set the tracker on the screen here. I'm just going to see how quickly I can go within maybe like, I don't know, just give it like 5 or 10 minutes and see how much experience I can get, and then I can kind of gauge how long those grinds will take. Alright, there we go, level 17 agility, so about 3k experience an hour. It's very click intensive and it's very annoying to do, so I'll probably do like one level segments at a time. It's only 408 experience until level 18, so that's not too bad. That'll only take less than 10 minutes, but it's really annoying. I'll come back here at a later time and knock out a couple levels. I just wanted to test to see just how quickly I can get experience. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and get some general levels up here. I need level 50 woodcutting for Olaf's quest, 55 for Lunar Diplomacy, and 56 for Fremy Isles. So it's very important. Olaf's quest at level 50 gives me access to the Skeleton Fremenix, which drop a lot of runes that I'll need for my magic grind later on. And as well as doing this, I'm going to fletch these into oak longbows for the maximum experience. And then at level 61 fletching, I can make an adamant crossbow. So I can buy the parts in Keldgrim and then just get bear meat for the crossbow string, and that'll be my best in slot range weapon that I'll probably end up taking to the DKs once I get that far. And there we have level 31 woodcutting, so I can now ditch the bronze axe and go right up to the Addy axe. It's going to improve my XP quite a bit. And there we have level 40 woodcutting. Following level 40 woodcutting is level 40 fletching. That opens up willow longbows and battle staves, none of which are relevant to me. And there we have level 45 woodcutting. So there's actually one maple tree right here that I can cut inside my boundaries. So when I get the fletching level high enough, I may head over there just so I can make maple short or longbows and try and pick up the experience a little bit faster. Following 45 woodcutting is 45 fletching. And there we have level 50 woodcutting, so I think I'm going to stop there. Level 50 woodcutting allows me to progress far enough in Olaf's quest to reach the Skeleton Fremenix, which is going to be one of my best sources of runes early on. And along with level 50 woodcutting, we also picked up level 47 fletching, so another 7 levels and I can make a Mithril crossbow, and then I think at 61 is when I can do an Adamant crossbow, which I think is my overall main goal on fletching. But anyways, I'm going to head back to do a little bit of agility, maybe get 1 or 2 levels. It's only going to take 10 or 15 minutes. It's just really click intensive, but I'll chime back in once I get a level. And there is the first agility level, level 18, picking about 3.8k an hour. It's not as bad as I thought. I just have to really pay attention and pretty much just right click and then left click once I land. So it's very click intensive, but I think that's the fastest way I could go. So I'll check back in when I hit level 19. And there we have level 19 agility. So that took about 7 minutes from 18 to 19. Overall, not too bad at 3,700 at level 18 or 19 agility. And that's not too bad. It's just that I need to get level 35 for Horror from the Deep. And once I hit about level 30, those are going to take a long time to get levels. Decided to knock out one more agility level, so there is level 20 agility. That one took about just under 10 minutes to get. A little bit slower of a pace. I think I'll stop there for now and come back at a later time. And there we have level 40 fire making. I realized I needed 40 fire making to go along with the 50 wood cutting for Olaf's quest, so now I can go into the cave that has the skeleton Fremenix, and I can also complete the quest as well. And I also picked up two more wood cutting levels, so level 52. Well, I've fallen about 5 or 6 times in a row, so I'm gonna go just kill some skeleton Fremenix and just see what the drops are like. There we go, 73% possible reward. Let's hope for some runes. And we had 18 and then jumped up to 191, so 173 chaos and 86 death runes. That is incredible. These maze randoms are probably my only way of getting death runes for quite some time, and the amount of chaos runes I give to is just unmatched. So as mentioned in previous clips, the Skeleton Fremenix are going to be my best way of obtaining runes going forward to get to level 65 for Lunar Diplomacy. They drop common air runes in stacks of 60, which is what I need most. And also along with that, I need the Chaos runes and the Law runes, and I guess the Cosmic runes as well. The Water runes aren't as important, but I do need those as well. And after my first 100 kills, I'm going to go ahead and just throw on the loot tracker here. I picked up 5 drops of Chaos Runes, which is an uncommon drop, and then I only got 3 of the common Air Runes, which is most likely on drop rate. Only 1 Cosmic drop, and then a few Law drops as well, and Water drops. So I'm thinking I'm going to have to kill probably 5,000 to 10,000 of these, just so I can get as many runes stockpiled as possible, along with the Maze Random, and then I can get Earth Runes from the Trolls, and then the Hobgoblins also drop some other runes as well. But I think this is going to be one of my main goals going forward. I'm not sure when I'm going to tackle this just because it does require a lot of patience. And I need to get my stats up higher as well. Even though I have level 45 defense, they are still hitting me pretty hard. So I'll have to make a plan around that and maybe get into the mid 50s in my stats before coming back. Back at my favorite oak trees, and with this next fletch, it will give me level 50 fletching. And that's going to be enough to make maple short bows. Maple short bows give the same experience as these oak shields, but only take 1 log. I'm going to head over to that one maple tree and see what the XP rates are like. I think it's going to be a little bit more AFK because I do cut these oak trees rather fast, so hopefully that's going to turn out to be better experience. And there we have level 55 woodcutting. That is my first requirement done for the Lunar Diplomacy quest. I'm getting about 21k an hour at this maple tree. I was getting that about at the oak trees as well. But this is a little bit more AFK, so I may just stick with this, and as my levels go up, I should be able to get higher XP rates. Crafting is another requirement that I need to get up for some quests, as well as I need level 43 for yak hide armor. I do have some seaweed, and I can get buckets of sand from Relica, so there we go. Level 17 crafting, making molten glass. Unfortunately, I can't get a glass blowing pipe until I have the tool store in my player own house, but it is 20 experience per molten glass, so I will do this for a while, and then once I do get that tool store, I should have a lot of molten glass banked, so I can get a lot of crafting experience as well. There's some flax spawns outside of Relica, and there is a spinning wheel right here as well, so this is going to be a lot faster than molten glass. Even if I do bank the bowstrings, I think it's going to be still a lot faster. I can drop them, but I think I'm going to save them for fletching experience in the future. But there is level 18 crafting. Level 19 crafting. And there we have level 20 crafting. And there we have level 25 crafting. So I decided to drop the bowstrings as banking them just wasn't worth it time-wise. I was getting about 10k experience an hour doing this, dropping them on my way back here, and then picking up the flax right over outside of the gates. So again, like I mentioned earlier, the goal is 43 for Yakai, so quite a lot of bowstrings to go, but I think 25 is a good stopping point. And there we have level 56 woodcutting. So that's my last woodcutting requirement needed for the Fremnic Isles quest to make some Fremnic round shields with Arctic pine logs. So I'm gonna keep fletching though, because as mentioned earlier in the video, I do want to reach at least level 54 to make that myth crossbow, and then eventually 61. And that's going to do it for episode 3. I know this episode had a lot of skilling in it, but that's just early game Iron Man content as a whole, and restricted accounts are no different. I hope that in the next episode I can get through Horror from the Deep, so I'm going to need a lot of agility training. And also, I want to maybe start my Skeleton Fremnic grind as well, just so I can kind of get the magic experience rolling in. I have a couple of tricks that I want to try for magic XP all the way up to 65, so hopefully it all works out. But like I mentioned earlier in the video, my next video is going to have more of a roadmap of where I plan on going after Horror from the Deep, so I just have a little bit more transparency on the whole progress of the account. But if you did enjoy the video, feel free to hit a like, and if you haven't subscribed, that'd be great too. Almost 75% of people watching my videos aren't subscribed, so even if some of you do, let's try and get 5, 6, 7,000 subscribers.